in high school, you end up with, like in grade 9, doing this thing where you're like asking questions about, they're asking you, what do you want to be? And they give you a list of different careers. And I listed like zoologist, scientist, all this stuff in grade 9. So in grade 9, I already knew what I wanted to do. Obviously, very fortunate that, it's all worked out. And I'm pretty much doing exactly what I wanted to do since I was a kid. I'm an evolutionary ecologist, and I work on mammals mostly, but we've worked on insects, we've worked on reptiles, I have a student working on birds. And so we're using physiological techniques, genetic techniques, to try to answer questions about fitness and natural selection. So we're interested in what kind of traits are important in terms of acquiring reproductive success in natural animal populations. So we focus on red squirrels, flying squirrels in Algonquin Park. We've done a lot of work on mink, on domestic mink, escaping from mink farms, and the fitness consequences of these mink interbreeding with wild mink. And we're now working with the Toronto Zoo. So we're trying to use the principles of evolutionary ecology to try to understand how we can enhance the health and reproductive programs of these endangered species. But we're starting a big project now looking at the effects of urbanization on natural populations of animals. And so we're going to use Sudbury as a test area. So the interesting thing about Sudbury is that you've got natural areas that are quite close to urban areas. So that makes it a bit of an interesting sort of natural laboratory for these kinds of questions about how animals are adapting to the presence of humans. So humans, there's a lot of environmental change that's been very rapid, and so we're trying to understand what are the consequences of that rapid environmental change on selection and evolution of these natural animal populations.